Good morning. A couple of announcements before we begin. We apparently ran out of bulletins, which is an interesting thing. So if couples both have a bulletin, is there some that you could share your bulletin? And raise your hand if you need a bulletin. We'll give them to the ushers and you can collect them. Thank you. There you go. Anybody else need one? All right, so Krista will have some if you need one. Okay, right behind you there. Thank you very much. Then those of you who are reading the parts for the Passion play, you will stay in your seats and just read it from your seats. I really want this to feel like a congregational thing. And for the congregation, if you would look in that booklet, turn it up to page 2. I just want to point out what your part is, because the congregation has a big part in this. So page 2, right at the beginning, your first line is not during the festival. Does everybody see that? It's bold and it's got a little leaf next to it. So those are your lines when we get to that in the congregational reading. And for those of you who are speaking the extra parts, thank you so much for doing this. Please relax and enjoy this. We are here to dwell in the word of the Lord and to listen to the story of the 3 days. Good morning again, and welcome to worship at Augustana Lutheran Church. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We begin with the blessing. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this, 'The Lord needs it, and will send it back here immediately.' They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, 'What are you doing untying the colt?' They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, 'Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven.' Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. The Lord be with you and also with you. Let's raise our palms. We praise you, O God, for redeeming the world through our Savior, Jesus Christ. Today he entered the holy city in triumph and was proclaimed Messiah and King by those who spread garments and branches along his way. Bless these branches and those who carry them. Grant us grace to follow our Lord in the way of the cross so that, joined to his death and resurrection, we enter into life with you. Through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us go forth in peace. In the name of Christ, amen.
Thank you.
of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We pray together the prayer of the day found in your bulletin. As we now enter into the contemplation of the Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ and meditate on the salvation of the world through his sufferings, death and burial, and resurrection, let us pray. Everlasting God, in your endless love for the human race, you sent our Lord Jesus Christ to take on our nature and to suffer death on the cross. In your mercy, enable us to share in his obedience to your will and in the glorious victory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. Good morning again, and once again, welcome to worship this morning. We celebrate the sacrament of Holy Communion, and all are welcome at the Lord's table. Please proceed down the center aisle where you will receive the bread, and then step to either side to receive the wine. Return your empty cups in the baskets provided. There's wine and white grape juice available, and also gluten-free wafers. If you need one of those, please let me know. Our services are being recorded in real time, and then they are posted for viewing later on in the afternoon. This service this morning is being recorded. We keep in our prayers Karen Anderson, Barb Faust Sparks, Christina Graham, Dan Baker, and Laura Herrick. The Holy Week schedule is in the bulletin. One thing I did want to highlight is the fundraiser for those going to the youth gathering, which is the Easter breakfast. Serving times are 7:30 and 9:30 a.m. We continue with the readings.
Our first reading this morning is from...
Thank you.
Our first reading is from Isaiah. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backwards. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from the insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me, therefore I have not been disgraced. Therefore I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me, who will declare me guilty. The word of the Lord. Our psalm today is Psalm 31. We'll say it responsively. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am in trouble, for my eye is consumed with sorrow, and also my throat and my belly. For my life is wasted with grief, and my years with sighing. My strength fails me because of affliction, and my bones are consumed. I am the scorn of all my enemies, a disgrace to my neighbors, a dismay to my acquaintances. When they see me in the street, they avoid me. Like the dead, I am forgotten. Out of mind, I am as useless as a broken pot. For I have heard the whispering of the crowd. Fear is all around. They put their heads together against me. They plot to take my life.
But as for me, I have trusted in you, O Lord.
My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me.
Let your face shine upon your servant. Save me in your steadfast love.
Our second reading is from Philippians. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking a form of a slave, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We turn now to the reading of the Passion of our Lord according to Mark. The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. It was 2 days before the Passover and the festival of unleavened bread. The chief priests and the scribes were looking for a way to arrest Jesus by stealth and kill him, for they said,
"Not during the festival, or when there may be a riot among the people."
While he was at Bethany in the house of Simon the leper, as he sat at the table, a woman came with an alabaster jar of very costly ointment of nard, and she broke open the jar and poured the ointment on his head. But some who were there said to one another in anger,
"Why was the ointment wasted in this way? For this ointment could have been sold for more than 300 denarii and the money given to the poor."
And they scolded her. But Jesus said,
"Let her alone. Why do you trouble her? She has performed a good service for me. For you always have the poor with you, and you can show kindness to them whenever you wish. But you will not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anointed my body beforehand for its burial. Truly I tell you, wherever the good news is proclaimed in the whole world, what she has done will be told in remembrance of her."
Then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. When they heard it, they were greatly pleased and promised to give him money. So he began to look for an opportunity to betray him. On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb is sacrificed, his disciples said to him,
"Where do you want us to go and make the preparations for you to eat the Passover?"
So he sent two of his disciples, saying to them,
"Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him, and wherever he enters, say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks, where is my guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, furnished and ready. Make preparations for us there."
So the disciples set out and went to the city, and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When it was evening, he came with the 12. And when they had taken their places and were eating, Jesus said,
"Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me."
They began to be distressed and to say to him one after another, "Surely not I." He said to them,
"It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the bowl with me. For the Son of Man goes as is written of him, but woe to the one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born."
While they were eating, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it and gave it to them and said,
"Take, this is my body."
Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, and all of them drank from it. He said to them,
"This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God."
When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives, and Jesus said to them,
"You will become deserters, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will scatter.' But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee."
Peter said to him,
"Even though all become deserters, I will not."
Jesus said to him,
"Truly I tell you, this day, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times.
But he said vehemently,
"Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you."
And all of them said the same. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and Jesus said to his disciples,
"Sit here while I pray."
He took with him Peter and James and John and began to be distressed and agitated. And he said to them,
"I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake."
And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that, if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. He said,
Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I want, but what you want.
He came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter,
Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak.
And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them,
Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough. The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up. Let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand.
Immediately while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. And with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying,
The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard.
So when he came, he went up to him at once and said,
Rabbi,
and kissed him. Then they laid hands on him and arrested him. But one of those who stood near drew his sword and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear. Then Jesus said to them,
Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I was with you in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled.
All of them deserted him and fled. A certain young man was following him, wearing nothing but a linen cloth. They caught hold of him, but left the linen cloth, and he ran off naked. They took Jesus to the high priest, and all the chief priests, the elders, and the scribes were assembled. Peter had followed him at a distance, right into the courtyard of the high priest, and he was sitting with the guards, warming himself at the fire. Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none. For many gave false testimony against him, and their testimony did not agree. Some stood up and gave false testimony against him, saying,
We heard him say, I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another, not made with hands.
But even on this point, their testimony did not agree. Then the high priest stood up before them and asked Jesus,
Have you no answer? What is it that you testify? What is it that they testify against you?
But he was silent and did not answer. Again, the high priest asked him,
Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One?
Jesus said,
I am, and you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven.
Then the high priest tore his clothes and said,
Why do we still need witnesses? You have heard his blasphemy. What is your decision?
All of them condemned him as deserving death. Some began to spit on him, to blindfold him, and to strike him, saying to him, Prophesy! The guards also took him over and beat him. While Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the servant girls of the high priest came by. When she saw Peter warming himself, she stared at him and said,
You also were with Jesus, the man from Nazareth.
But he denied it, saying,
I do not know or understand what you are talking about.
And he went out into the forecourt. Then the cock crowed, and the servant girl, on seeing him, began again to say to the bystanders,
This man is one of them.
But again he denied it. Then, after a little while, the bystanders again said to Peter,
Certainly you are one of them, for you are a Galilean.
But he began to curse, and he swore an oath,
I do not know this man you are talking about.
At that moment, the cock crowed for the second time. Then Peter remembered that Jesus had said, Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times. And he broke down and wept. As soon as it was morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate asked him,
Are you the king of the Jews?
He answered him,
"You say so."
Then the chief priests accused him of many things. Pilate asked him again,
"Have you no answer? See how many charges they bring against you."
But Jesus made no further reply, so that Pilate was amazed. Now at the festival, he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone for whom they asked. Now a man called Barabbas was in prison with the rebels who had committed murder during the insurrection. So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to his custom. Then he answered them,
"Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?"
For he realized that it was out of jealousy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate spoke to them again.
"Then what do you wish me to do with the man you call king of the Jews?"
They shouted back,
"Crucify him."
Pilate asked them,
"Why? What evil has he done?"
But they shouted all the more,
"Crucify him."
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them. And after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is the governor's headquarters, and they called together the whole cohort, and they clothed him in a purple cloak, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him, and they began saluting him.
"Hail, King of the Jews!"
They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him. They compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry his cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus. Then they brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull. And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him they crucified two bandits, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads and saying,
"Ah, you who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross."
In the same way, the chief priests, along with the scribes, were also mocking him among themselves and saying,
"He saved others. He cannot save himself. Let the Messiah, the King of Israel, come down from the cross now, so that we may see and believe."
Those who were crucified with him also taunted him. When it was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out with a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani,"
which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said,
"Listen, he is calling for Elijah."
And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick and gave it to him to drink, saying,
"Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down."
Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now when the centurion who stood facing him saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said,
"Truly, this man was God's son."
There were also some women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James the Younger and of Joseph, and Salome. They used to follow him and provided for him when he was in Galilee. And there were many other women who had come up with him to Jerusalem. When evening had come, and since it was the day of preparation, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a respected member of the council, who was also himself waiting expectantly for the kingdom of God, went boldly to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate wondered if he were already dead, and summoning the centurion, he asked him whether he had been dead for some time. When he learned from the centurion that he was dead, he granted the body to Joseph. Then Joseph bought a linen cloth, and taking down the body, wrapped it in the linen cloth, and laid it in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock. He then rolled a stone against the door of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, saw where the body was laid. We continue with the prayers. Trusting in God's promise to reconcile all things, let us pray for the church, the well-being of creation, and a world in need. Blessed One, today the church sings glad hosannas as we enter Holy Week. Prepare us to bear witness to Christ's suffering and death endured for our sake. Gather your people around the cross and comfort us with resurrection hope. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Renew your good creation and protect the balance of life on earth. Encourage the work of foresters, scientists, arborists, gardeners, and river keepers. We pray for the health of pollinating insects, songbirds, and native plants. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Establish peace and justice among the nations. Hold to account any with authority to judge others. Grant that courts, legislatures, and local governments will serve with integrity and compassion. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Bring hope to any who feel forsaken or forgotten. Make a way for refugees and asylum seekers. Reunite families enduring separation. We pray for any who are incarcerated, institutionalized, or in foster care, that they may know your love. We pray also for all those who are sick or in need, especially Karen Anderson, Barb Faust Sparks, Christina Graham, Dan Baker, and all those we name in our hearts. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Give energy and joy to our pastors, deacons, worship leaders, and musicians. Bless baptismal candidates, their sponsors, confirmands, and teachers. Watch over those who travel. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Gracious God, you have granted to us the gifts we need to find the leader of your nurturing. Help us to be faithful as we wait for that leader to enter our lives. Sustain the call committee as they continue to serve this congregation. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Blessed One, our times are in your hand. Sustain us in discipleship throughout our lives and receive us into everlasting life. We give thanks for the courage of Oscar Romero, bishop and martyr whom we commemorate today. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Accompany us on our journey, God of grace, and receive the prayers of our hearts through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share a word of peace with our neighbor. With you. It's okay, you're fine. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. You may be seated for the offering. Please stand. Let us pray. Jesus, you are the bread of life and the host of this meal. Bless these gifts that we have gathered that all people may know your goodness. Feed us not only with this holy food, but with hunger for justice and peace. We pray this in your name. Amen. The Lord be with you. Your hearts. merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, whose suffering death and death gave salvation to all. You gather your people around the tree of the cross, transforming death into life, and so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending God, our living word and our merciful guide, together with rivers and seas, wells and springs, we bless and magnify you. You led your people Israel through the desert and provided them water from the rock. We praise you for Christ, our rock and our water, who joined us in our desert, pouring out his life for the world. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his life, death, and resurrection, we await your salvation for all this thirsty world. Pour out your Spirit on this holy food and on all the baptized gathered for this feast. Wash away our sin, that we may be revived for our journey by the love of Christ. Through him all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Bread for the journey, a feast for hungry hearts. Come, please be seated.
Thank you.
Please stand. Let us pray. Generous God, at this table we have tasted your immeasurable grace. As grains of wheat are gathered into one bread, now make us one loaf to feed the world. In the name of Jesus, the bread of life, amen. Beloved, we are God's own people, holy, washed, renewed. God bless you and keep you, shower you with mercy, fill you with grace, and give you peace. Amen. My thanks again to all of our readers for the Passion story. Go in peace, share your bread. Thanks be to God.